I can't believe it. My person has rediscovered the joys of playing fetch with her dog.
Ruffinkins, where did you go?
She's throwing the balls everywhere in the yard. I even have to fetch balls from the pool. The pool!
Ruffy, come out here and fetch right now.
Ah, woof, woof. Give me a minute. All right, I only have a minute to dry off and get a quick snack. Luckily, I've come up with two awesome inventions. First, for the dog who needs help drying off, the Shake It CD and Dance Mat. Here, Chet.
Unshake, unshake and shake and dry that fur and shake and dry that tail and shake, yeah!
Yeah! Hey! Oh, yeah, a towel would work too.
Ruffy Poo, come out to Mama!
Yikes!
I need to get back out there. But first, my snackerator! It's gonna sweep the dog world! You put your kibble here, and in no time at all, it dispenses a tasty snack. Ow! Ah!
Ruffy, come now!
Ow!
Life was missing its mystique. My squeaky toys had lost their squeak. And then, out of the blue, I saw the phone, and bam! My destiny was calling me. Pitched my vision for a show. They loved it, thought I was a pro. They got my contract back to find. To their alarm, a dog had signed. Oh, I like that name. I didn't wait to renovate, found six contestants, all were great. And now I'm on the road to fame, I've got a game show and its name is... It's very catchy. It rolls off the tongue.
Blossom, you want to remind me why I hired Chet?
And here come the contestants now!
His cat Fluffy likes to drink out of the toilet. Charming. In sixth place, it's Punch! He hates when he forgets what he was going to say. What do I say? Oh, in fifth place, it's Jay. She always reads in bed before going to sleep. In fourth place, it's Jimmy. For Halloween, she dressed up like a game of solitaire. In third place, it's Ruby. His best subject in school is math. In second place, it's Marco. She wants to be a gastroenterologist. That's a tummy doctor. In first place, it's Freya!
Hi, and welcome again to Fetch, the reality game show where human beings do the fetching, not dogs.
That's right.
That's you.
My person, she's rediscovered the joys of playing fetch with her dog.
Ruffy Doodles, time for fetchies. Bring your tennis ball.
You see what I mean? Oh. She's running me ragged.
Oh.
She throws the ball everywhere. The patio, the pool, which brings me to challenge number one.
Ooh.
Yeah. Emmy, Shreya, build me a flying carpet.
What?
You know, something I can ride over land and sea to fetch stuff. This is Pecco. She's an engineer,
and you might recognize her from my bicycle challenge.
Now, how to find her and everything else you need to know is in the mailbox. So,
Ruffy Poo, go fetch!
Oh, go!
Just a minute, I'm coming! Woof, woof, woof! I am!
Now, what my person doesn't understand is that certain dogs prefer a life of ease and convenience, which is why I put my best mouse on the job. Chet, I asked you to invent something to make my life easier. So what do you got? Edible cheese socks. Okay. Challenge number two. Come up with something more convenient than edible cheese socks. You know, my great-great-great-great-grandfather Raphael Rachmaninoff was a famous inventor. He even invented this self-portrait that talks when you press this button.
Hey, you! What's brown and sticky?
A cinnamon bun?
What?
A stick!
Great. Jay, Marco, you can invent something better than that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, something that's actually useful. Everything you need to know is in that mailbox. So go fetch!
Yeah.
Bye!
As determined by the Fetch 3000. Mark and Ruby have stayed behind in the studio, but they'll be eligible to win points during the
halftime quiz show.
And we bake our Fetch Fairness guarantees fresh every morning. All the contestants will have competed for the same number of points by the grand finale. So, for the four kids out on the challenges, up to 100 points are at stake in the triumph tally. Now let's check in on Emmy and Shreya.
You must be the fetchers.
Hi, I'm Pecco.
This is the shop.
Ruff doesn't really like to fetch.
So we need to figure out some way to get him to fetch so he doesn't have to do any work.
I'm exhausted. I'm not meant to exercise.
So he needs something he can ride on. Something like
that. Yeah, that would work.
I think we can help him out with that. I'm going to let you play a couple rounds of air hockey, and you're going to tell me how the table works.
Wait a minute, we don't have time to play games, ladies. We need to develop something for me to get... I can't help it. Air hockey's awesome.
Goal!
Let's try another round, only this time let's play with the air off.
Well, that's not fun if you do it that.
Keep from stopping. Before you just hit softly and go like really far, now you gotta put more into it to make it get to the other side.
When the air is turned off, the puck and the table just rub together, slowing it down.
So do you know what that's called?
Friction.
Friction. When you need to move something, you have to apply a force. And if it's sliding on a surface, there's a frictional force from that surface which is pushing in the opposite direction. So now if I want to reduce that frictional force, I can turn on the air.
Now it moves easy peasy.
Notice I apply just a tiny little force and this thing glides in this direction because I've reduced the frictional force going back.
Ah, because the puck's kind of floating on the air.
So what do you think would happen if we turned off friction altogether?
It never stopped moving.
What's the only way you can make it stop or turn or speed up?
If there's force.
So I could add a frictional force or I could add some other force. For example, when you use these paddles, you're applying a force to this thing.
Like when Blossom uses her paddle to block my shots. Every time.
Wouldn't it be great if we could build something for Ruff that floats on a little cushion of air that he could ride?
They're gonna make me a vehicle! Ooh.
We obviously can't poke holes in the ground and have air coming out everywhere.
Maybe instead of the floor having holes coming out, what he's riding on could have holes coming out.
Good idea. I like that.
Ruffy Pie, get the bully!
Okay, let's go.
Okay, here comes Jay and Marco.
Hey, are you Ed?
I am!
Whoa!
I'm Ed. You're at a place called Continuum. We invent and create things to make people's lives better.
What is that thing?
This is a microphone that you can throw around an auditorium, so anybody who wants to say something, you just throw them the mic.
Ruff, this is amazing. We're gonna make your life so much better.
Thank you, Jay. I appreciate that.
Inventors are people who solve problems. Inventors use the design process. You have to know the problem that you're gonna solve, brainstorm ideas, choose the best one, build a model of it, and then test that model and make it better and better and better. Rain is a problem, right?
Uh-huh.
This is an umbrella, which is a solution, and this umbrella you don't have to hold.
Oh.
Do you use computers in school?
Mm-hmm.
One problem is that there are some kids who live in places where there isn't electricity. This is a laptop where a kid makes their own electricity with this generator.
A green laptop! And it's green!
This is a dog bone that's a toothbrush. You give it to the dog, they chew on it, and it cleans their teeth.
Nice.
This is really a rough Sally because I don't think I've ever seen him brush his teeth.
Well, I don't think I've ever seen you brush your teeth either. Maybe you should gnaw on the rubber bone.
We're gonna build a hovercraft for Ruff. A piece of plywood, so that's what Ruff's gonna sit on. Then we have to create a cushion of air, so we're gonna use this piece of plastic. Yep, and we're just gonna fold it over.
Watch the staples, ladies.
And we wanna make a good seal.
Can never use enough duct tape on this show.
Okay, so what we're gonna need to do is cut out these holes out of the plastic.
What are the holes for? Oh, that was Emmy's bright idea. Okay, so the air comes out of holes in the hovercraft instead of out of the ground, and that makes the cushion of air it rides on.
What we are going to use is one of these guys.
A leaf blower.
A leaf blower.
That's kind of like a vacuum cleaner, and we're scared of vacuum cleaners.
Did you like doing this kind of stuff when you were a kid?
I took apart every alarm clock in our house.
And you put them back together?
And I put them back together.
So you must really have a good sense of how things work.
The best way to figure out how things work is to take them apart. You might want to ask your parents before you start taking apart things at home.
Time to test.
Whoa, cool!
Man, look at that thing move! It works! It's the world's largest air hockey puck!
Ruffalicious! Fetch the stick!
Ah, come on!
Jake and Matt are designers here at Continuum, and they are going to help you come up with an invention to make Ruff's life better.
We can think about Ruff and think about the things that Ruff does day to day.
So Marco, I'm going to ask you to kind of close your eyes, pretend you're Ruff, and we're going to walk through his day.
Okay, you're me. You're a handsome dog.
So you're sleeping. The alarm goes off.
Hit the snooze button.
Now he's ready to get up.
He probably has to get up and have something to eat.
I like to eat.
What does he do?
I don't think he would take a shower.
Does he scratch himself? Is that kind of his shower?
Yeah.
I am a dog. We do scratch.
At that point, he might want to go out for a walk. He'd probably go for a walk.
By himself?
Maybe with Chet.
Walking? Everybody's got me exercising around here. Mmm, ooh, that's tasty.
A normal treadmill, and then Ruff would be running here.
Oh, that's a cute idea, but you know, what I really need is something that walks for me.
And then there could be a small treadmill for Chet to run on.
Oh, look at that! It's a little treadmill for Chet!
Now what we want to do is figure out the problem.
Well, maybe he wouldn't want the same dog food every day. So maybe if he had a device that gave him different types of dog food each time he wanted it.
Different types of dog food? That would be great.
Like a container with like little kettles that the dog can easily push down.
Okay.
And it can send out a certain amount of dog food.
Scratching himself, that takes some effort.
Not bad.
Is there an easier way?
Personal masseuse? Personal scratcher? Ooh, keep it up, Chet.
I was thinking maybe like a back scratcher.
Ooh, I like it.
Okay. Let's dig a little bit deeper into the massage idea.
Maybe like a motorized, like rollers.
Rollers. Now, what kind of texture is on these rollers?
Well, all different textures, like soft and kind of rough.
A container.
Split into three different
parts.
We need a dish to get down there. And maybe like a little chute that puts whatever dog food comes out into the bowl.
Ah, perfect. Okay. I've got both teams of fetchers designing things for me. I'm a sharp dog.
You're about as sharp as a beach ball.
Ruffykins!
Oh.
How can you propel yourself forward and how can you turn?
Oh, maybe if he had an oar, he could push himself.
Oh, so you need to use the friction between the oar and the ground.
I don't want to use oars because I don't want to have to use my arms.
So, we have a bunch of stuff over there to try to steer this. Try those first.
These are weights.
There's compressed air in here.
So okay. Start with the oars.
Start with the oars. Okay.
Right,
weight
oars.
Distributed.
Look at that. It's like a boat on land.
The oar was a fail.
You couldn't grip the floor as well. Whereas that one might grip the floor a little bit better.
We'll try a broom.
Oh yeah, that's pretty good.
Now the broom worked better than the oar.
Started off okay, but not so great for stopping.
I kind of want to try something with the air.
Hey, whatever works. Why not?
It's really powerful, so it'll just propel backwards.
Right, so there's a general principle here, which says for every action there's a reaction.
Isn't that one of Newton's laws? I think that's first law. Third law, yes!
So maybe we can try it with the ball first.
I'm definitely ready to prove Newton's third law.
Oh, she's going in the other direction.
Cool. Throwing the ball is the action, and the hovercraft moving in the opposite direction is the reaction. Blossom, what are you doing? You're demonstrating action and reaction with a balloon? The air rushing out is like throwing that big ball, and it makes the balloon fly off in the opposite direction. Well, now it's time to go in a different direction, toward Studio G. Ha-ha! With Ruby and Mark, it's time for the Halftime Quiz Show.
All right.
Let's brush up on the rules. 50 points are available. You have 60 seconds to answer as many questions as you can. 10 questions available at 5 points apiece. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Then let the quiz begin! The purpose of the air in the air hockey table is to get rid of what?
friction.
Yes. True or false, if there were no friction to slow down the puck on the air hockey table, the puck would never stop moving.
True.
Yes. Wow. What invention does Jay try on?
Oh, the umbrella.
Yes. Name two things Emmy and Shreya use to propel and steer their hovercraft.
A broom and an oar.
Excellent. The dog bone invention. What purpose does it serve other than being a dog bone?
Teeth brushing. It brushes their teeth.
Yes. If you're sitting on a hovercraft and you throw a heavy ball to the right, will your hovercraft move to the right or left?
Left.
Yes. To make anything stop or speed up or turn, you must do what?
Upforce.
Yes. Jay mentioned several things in his brainstorm session that I like to do on a daily basis. Name one of them.
Eat.
Yes. To create an air cushion, the air must come from the ground. True or false?
False.
Yes. I can control Jay's invention with blank.
Your paw on the pedal.
10 out of 10. Oh, baby. Sweet biscuits. 50 points. Awesome job, guys.
Yeah.
Well, Chet has just created hover pajamas. And they're completely useless, Chet. Let's check in with Emmy and Shreya and see if they're doing better than Chet.
Hey!
Wow, will you look at that? The compressed air works too. Let me give these guys a call. Hey, guys.
Hey, is that Ruff?
That's Ruff.
Oh, hey, Ruff.
I've arranged a fetch-off with some of the neighborhood dogs.
What's a fetch-off?
A fetch-off. We're all going to fetch. Whoever gets the best time is the best fetching dog in the neighborhood.
Is our hovercraft fast enough for that?
Yeah, well, about that, Ruff.
Yeah, well, the big problem is we don't have space here in Studio G for the fetch-off. We need somebody's house, so it's a really long driveway.
Okay. You guys want to come to my house?
All right! Tank will meet you all at Emmy's house with the supplies. I'll see you there.
Hey, Rich.
Hey.
So what do you guys have? You have your designs ready to go?
Yep.
Come on with me.
Yeah.
Thanks, Rich.
Bye.
Thank you, gentlemen.
This is the model shop. This is where we build everything we design.
All right, time to build a model.
Jeez, Ruff, this is like being in an airport.
What? I can't hear you, Jay. It sounds like you're in an airport.
Hold that up right there. Excellent.
Now I'm going to apply these knobs to the surface of this rod.
Let's test it out.
Now it's time to test. Nice. If I'm going to eat bolts and nuts. Now for the different flavors. Chicken, beef, and egg roll. Oh, that's a good one.
3, 2, 1.
Bingo! Chow time.
Let's test it out.
How's it feel?
Oh, that's great.
Feels good?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Oh, I'm going to be so relaxed.
Hey.
What's going on?
What's this?
This is supposed to be like a dog back scratcher massager type thing.
I like it.
Mine is a 3-compartment dog food holder.
Cool.
You don't really know how great your design is until you try to sell it. So we're going to send you to a store that sells just dog stuff. And you're going to sell it to the owners and see what they say.
Cool. Let's pitch some products to a dog expert.
Thanks, Rich.
Ruffy Tuffy Tuffy.
I am trying to run a show here.
Whoa, Shreya, check it out.
Look at that, huh? Nice job, Tank.
So this is the course. A tennis ball is going to be thrown into the wading pool. You have to fetch the tennis ball out of the pool and bring it back.
Cool.
And you are going to be racing against a number of dogs.
Ooh, tough competition.
Hey, is that a hose?
Yeah.
Are we allowed to use that to pull ourselves up?
You are allowed to use any equipment lying around here.
I bet the water would be a stronger force than the air, right?
Ooh,
to push us?
Oh, yes. And our first contender is Trek.
Whoa, Trek. That's a fierce competitor right there. Look at that ball in the pool. Trek gets it. Brings it back.
Oh, this is a good one.
Wow, that was quick. What's the time on that?
9 seconds.
Whoa. Girls have their work cut out for them.
Next up, we've got Roxy.
All right, Roxy.
Go.
Roxy, where are you going? The ball is that. Right, we threw the ball already. Yes, Roxy.
Roxy, we have a chance to beat this dog. There we go,
Roxy. That's it, finally. Thanks for playing. Okay, now bring it back. Bring it.
Ruff,
But where are you going?
And Roxy clocks in at 2 minutes.
Woo! Yay, Roxy. 120 seconds. That's 2 minutes if you're keeping score at home.
Okay, next up we have a very excited contestant, Tyler.
There we go. Boom. Go get it, Tyler. There we go. Got the ball. And we bring it back, of course.
10 seconds.
10 seconds. Oh, missed track by 1 second.
Okay, Holly, you ready?
Oh, there's Holly.
Come on.
Okay, ball goes into the pool. Holly, need to, what? Oh, hey, not everybody's used to being on TV. Come on, Holly. You just gotta go get the ball, buddy.
We might have to go with a disqualification on Holly.
All right, Holly's out. This is a half-hour show.
Next up, we have Sophie.
Go get it.
Go, Sophie! Oh, too far.
In the woods.
Come on. All right, she got the ball. Let's bring it back. Now we're gonna take the scenic route.
Sophie? Sophie, are you coming?
Oh, she went into the neighbor's.
What's the matter? Oh, come on! That's just awful. Okay, the time to beat is 9 seconds.
Okay, so this is it. This is our one chance. Do you guys know what you're going to use for propulsion?
Yes, our air tank and the hose.
I'll put the broom and the oar down there.
Okay, that's good.
We can
so
just be kind of like...
Just hand her whatever she needs.
Get set, go!
Go, Shreya, go!
Go!
And now the net. And the scooping of the tennis ball. Awesomeness. Now we switch to the hose. Then Emmy is getting soaking wet. And Shreya is on her way back. What do we got?
37 seconds!
37 seconds! Shrek wins with 9 seconds. Our fetchers came in third.
Technically, you did use the oar to push her. That was absolute transfer of forces. That's exactly what we were working on here.
Successful fetching with a homemade hovercraft. This will really help me with my fetching.
Thank you for helping us out, Pecco.
See you back
at Studio G, Ralph.
See you back at Studio G, ladies. Polka Dog Bakery.
Hey.
I'm Rob.
Hey, Rob.
All right, well, tell me a little bit about him.
Well, this is kind of designed for dogs to, like, lay on and just kind of move themselves and get their bellies scratched.
Well, I can tell you very honestly that I've never seen anything like this.
Is that a good thing?
It's a pretty interesting idea. We all know that dogs like belly rubs. Awesome. What do you got, Jay?
So this is the basic design. You have 3 compartments with each type of food. There's 3 little pedals and...
Voila!
Goes right in.
Perfect.
Wow. Very cool. Like with Marco, I haven't seen anything like this, so you guys really did an excellent job.
The dog shop owner says it's awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know what's really interesting with both of your guys' ideas here is that they could also be used for cats.
What?
This could really work for both cats and dogs.
Yeah, but you know, we're not really interested in that. Let us welcome back our contestants. Riding on a cushion of air, back to Studio G, Emmy and Shreya. Right behind them, 2 heroes who have devoted their lives, or at least a few hours, to make life better for dog kind. Jay and Marco.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, a few years ago, I came up with an invention myself. I call it the Triumph Tally.
Yeah!
Aha!
I like it.
Emmy, Shreya.
Wait just a minute.
For engineering an awesome hovercraft using a leaf blower and some duct tape, and for having fun while you did it, 80 points!
Whoa.
But that's not all. I've got another 5 points for Shreya!
Whoa.
For knowing about one of Newton's laws.
Isn't that one of Newton's laws?
That means Emmy, you've got yourself 80 points, and Shreya, you've got 85!
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Marco and Jay, an insta-kibble dispenser? A canine back massager? You call those good inventions?
Yes.
Well, I call them great inventions. 85 points.
Yeah.
Big deal. That's all the points. In my day, they would have gotten 1,000 points.
I don't know. Is that all the points a dog can give?
I don't think so.
What time is it?
Bonus points.
Today's 5 bonus points go to the fetcher, who designed a product not only for a dog, but also for a mouse.
Then there could be a small treadmill for Chet to run on.
Marco, for considering to build a treadmill for me and Chet, 5 points.
Yeah!
Fetch 3,000, what do we got? Marco with 90 points, you're today's daily winner.
Yeah!
Marco. I have here two novelty-talking self-portraits of my inventor ancestor, Raphael Rafmanowitz.
Over here, pick me! Nah, pick me! Listen, that one doesn't know what he's talking about. I don't know. You don't know!
So, which is it gonna be? Portrait A or Portrait B?
Well, the first guy sounds the most reliable, so I'm gonna go with A.
So, young man, go get your prize. It's in the mailbox.
There you go.
It's a hovercraft.
It is a hovercraft for mice. Now you two can have your mouse ride around in style.
Whoa, that's awesome. Whoa.
So, until next time, I'm Ruff Ruffman. We're out of here.
Bye.
See you soon. Okay, guys, let's see your new inventions. Here's mine, a combination hovercraft helmet toothbrush. Pretty awesome. What do you got? Wow, an actual hovercraft capable of reaching 400 miles per hour. That's pretty good, Blossom. What do you have, Chet? A hover cheese? I didn't even know you could do that with cheese. What do you think, Raphael?
I think I've enjoyed hanging around with you guys. Get it? Hanging? Like on the wall?
How do we turn this thing off?
Hi.
Hey, you want to learn more about hovercrafts? Let's dig a little deeper. Just like the air hockey table, the hovercraft uses air to overcome friction.
Oh, yes.
Because without the air...
Definitely nothing happens.
Oh, yes. It keeps on stopping.
But with the air reducing friction, the hovercraft can really fly.
Nice.
I've always known there's more to learn from air hockey. Okay, one last thing. Not only do I host my own television show, but I have a fantastic website, too. Check it out. It's more fun than turning round and round in circles before a nap. PBSKidsGo.org.